He did indeed. We were expecting fast and furious snooker and lots of breaks and tons, and we didn't get any of that. What we got was an intriguing game of snooker and a bit of Ronnie Luck thrown in, but he won't really care about any of that. All he cares about is the fact that he's the first player into the last four. He will play the Marco Fu or Mark Allen, and that will be on Saturday afternoon at 1 o'clock. Defending champion through to the last four, and there's confirmation of when we return. All live on Eurosport. Live coverage begins at 6:45. The match will start around about 7 o'clock. A strange old match, boys, because we spoke beforehand and we're all getting excited about it and we're expecting balls to be putting off lampshades and tons, and we even stupidly spoke about a possibility of a 147. We didn't get any of that, but what we did get was a lot of run and luck from O'Sullivan. I'm sure he'll talk about that, and he'll be the first when he comes in soon to tell us about that. But it was a strange old match because Neil hasn't been playing well all season, and I thought tonight was possibly, or this afternoon was possibly, an opportunity for him to step up. And when he had chances, Jimmy, he just couldn't take them.
No, he was, you know, he'd be disappointed, Robertson, because he had so many chances, and O'Sullivan struggled as well. I know he had a few flukes to help him through the match, but he struggled, and at this level, Robertson, you expect to take them chances, and, you know, it was a scrappy match. I think we've been spoilt with so many good matches. I think that, you know, that's the worst match so far.
Yeah, that's a good point. The luck started in frames 7 and 8. Neil, you've picked out a few of the shots. But you've got a feel for Neil, because if it's not going for you, it's not going for you. And this was a huge fluke.
Well, it's an outrageous fluke, actually. He doesn't take advantage of this one, and Ronnie has been known, but that is the most outrageous fluke you see, you know. And the trouble with Ronnie is, you know, and he almost feels ashamed to have done it, or embarrassed to have done it, and that's the shot he played next. So, OK, that didn't work out in his favour, but he had the chance to, and he eventually, you know, went on to win the frame with that shot. I think the fluke he got in the next frame, Jimmy, where he did decide, hey, hang on, I might as well take advantage, was even more outrageous, because Joe in commentary says he flicked the brown on the way through.
Yeah, no, this is mad. He's just touched the brown to put it online for the pocket, and Ronnie went, and he looks like... I don't think it's about the fluke where he's doing that, them expressions. I think he just can't believe he's missed the red.
Yeah.
And I suppose it also, Neil, it sort of underlines the fact that he's not playing well, because he's getting these flukes to continue a break, and it's a break we all expect him to do without the luck.
Yeah, Neil Robertson, better pot success in the match. It's just a stat, but it's a fact. You know, and it continued, actually. Funny enough, in the next frame, he got another fluke at an important time, you know, when... The frame which turned out to be the last frame was an odd one, really, in that, you know, both players were in trouble. Both players had the three strikes and out rule thrown at them a few times. On to frame 9. Look, this is really unlucky again. It's a horrible shot. He's gone in off. The in off's on, but it...
Nothing you can do about that. You can't look at that shot before you play and think, oh, the white might flick it.
Bad angle.
You can play that 20 times and not going off. And at the end, he's knocked the black in there, but he had no shot. Ronnie O'Sullivan put him in so much trouble. He tried to nestle on two balls, decided to go for one and missed it by a yard.
He was in proper Shredsville there.
Shredsville,
He really was.
I think he's the mayor of Shredsville
after
that. There
is just one other shot there. I mentioned that Ronnie was on the three strikes and out rule earlier in that frame. On the third go, he played a different shot, fluke to red.
No, mad. I don't think he's had so many flukes.
Yeah.
Be interesting to see what he says.
We're all big O'Sullivan fans, obviously, you know, not because he works here, but, you know, we like him and I love watching him play. But sometimes you have to be honest and say that, you know, if you're in the Neil Robertson camp, you'd be pretty hopping mad about the way the game went.
Yeah. And I thought the way it ended as well, with regards to Neil on the three strikes and out, where we had to go for everything, and he slammed the white down the table and the black went in. That was the foul. I thought that summed up his afternoon, Jim. When you don't get the run, when you know it's going against you, and not only that, your player's getting it, there's nothing you can do, is there?
No, it's you know, it's really frustrating. You know, Robertson will be pig sick, but at the same time, you know, if you leave O'Sullivan, even if he's struggling, O'Sullivan, you leave him like 50, easy 50, you know, he's not a better person at getting at him.
Yeah. What does that say, though, about Ronnie with regards to he's now into the last four of the Masters, defending champion, looking to win it for a record 7th time? He's not really played that well, you know. He was ill in his first match, he's somehow managed to get through this match, but he's into the last four. You've still got to fancy him, haven't you?
I'll go as far to say he hasn't played well at all. And, you know, when he comes in, I'm sure we'll get that from him, because we kind of know how he operates, don't we? But it wasn't a typical O'Sullivan way of winning. It was the kind of match we've seen that over 20 years, him lose matches like that. So the good thing is, you know, he's found ways of winning. And Neil Robertson's a little bit out of sorts. I mean, Jimmy pointed out, and he's right to say, you know, he's been out of form. He looks like he's coming out of it. But that will set him back a bit there, because that was a golden chance to beat O'Sullivan. And by luck, maybe, but also, as Jimmy said, he had his chances. And, you know, he came out second best on the day. It was probably closer than 6-3, but he's lost, unfortunately.
Let's remind ourselves of the draw. I said a couple of moments ago that win for Ronnie books his place in the last four. He's the first player out of the, what now, six remaining. Marco Fu against Mark Allen is our live game tonight. We're on air at 6:45. That one starts around about 7. In the bottom half, you've got Joe Perry against Ding Junhui and Hawkins against Mark Selby. Mark, of course, by his own admission, struggled through to get this far against Mark Williams. And I just wonder, Jimmy, if the big guns, the big names, the favourites are feeling slightly under the cosh in front of this incredible crowd we seem to be getting every day and night.
Well, the match between Mark Allen and Marco Fu will be very close, but they've got to play Ronnie O'Sullivan, you know, and they're going to be second favourite again. And, you know, for me, sometimes, you know, you have a bit of luck like he did to win the first match against Ian Wembo. Sometimes your name's on the trophy, and he's not played well against Robertson, who looked like, with the way he beat Carter, he's going to be a match for anyone. So, you know, you've got a fancy O'Sullivan-Selby final.
Yeah, how will Robertson take this defeat? Because, you know, he'll look back at it and think, how on earth did I lose that match? You know, no one really deserved to win it because no one shone on that table. But you've got to feel slightly for Neil, haven't you?
Yeah.
Because he just didn't get any luck at all.
No, he's suffering, but he's gone back to the drawing board. I think he'll work hard. He'll get his game back. Listen, he's a top player.
Yeah.
He is a top player. He's a hard worker, and he's a top player. And whatever he's not doing now, at some point in the season, he'll make up for, I think.
Also, this Masters tournament, everybody wants to win the Masters because it's top-heavy money and it's the London Masters. But at the end of the day, it's an invitation tournament. It doesn't hurt as much as losing in the UK or the World Championships because it's not a ranking tournament.
OK. Well, let me ask you, because a few players have mentioned the money, and it's, what, £200,000?
Yeah.
Do you think about that when you're out there, Jimmy? Does that enter your head?
It depends how, you know, how the horses have been going, but no. No, you really, no one really thinks about the money, but, you know, it is a big prize. You are playing for a lot of money when you get to the final. You're playing a match for £100,000. It's a great buzz.
Sorry, Jim. The other thing about that is there's another £200,000 tournament now, the China Championship, which John Higgins won. So this is the same prize money, but I think if you could pick one of the two, as much as that's a good tournament, and John Higgins delighted to win it, probably like to win here more because it's the Masters. So the money means so much, but the history of this event means more.
Okay, what about other things? Like, we saw Mark Selby talking about maybe a little bit of added pressure because he wants to win the Triple Crown. Ronnie, of course, wants to make it a record 7. These things come into it as well?
Yeah, with the players like that, you know, with their such top CVs, they want to add to it all the time. And, you know, Sullivan to win 7 Masters, and for Selby, you know, he'd want to win this for CV more than the money and more than the trophy. He wants to be, you know, to win 3 tournaments in one season.
OK, let's just have a quick look at the match stats, and then we'll be able to have a chat with the winner, Ronnie O'Sullivan, who, as you can see at the bottom of the screen, won by 6-3. But pot success, it's up there. That's not too bad. I think the one that will let him down there, Neil, in fact, both players, is long pot success. We know that Neil Robertson's game is all about the long game, and it wasn't there today. And Ronnie's also non-existent, 60% for Ronnie, just 67 for Neil. That's quite surprising.
Yeah, look at that stat at the top. Ice break 74, ice break 68. We mentioned the first 4 years of the Masters. There wasn't even a century. It's
almost right.
back like the mid-70s, playing with great big cannons for snooker balls, but a concrete, you know? I mean, that's a very surprising stat there. You know, and I think, look, Ronnie will be in soon, and when he does come in, he's probably got to work on all parts of his game. He wasn't scoring as well. His long game was a bit in and out. I thought the best part about Ronnie is the way he stuck at it today. He stuck at it really well. On another day in the past, he would have capitulated and not been himself. So all credit to him for that.
I'm always curious, as we hear so many players say, if I can take form from that match into the next one, how do you make sure you don't take form into the next match? What do you do?
For me, if that was me, you know, you've just got to forget all about that match. Just realise you're in the semi-final. And just get back practicing for the next day or so of what he's got, and, you know, just start again, because that was just a bad match. You've got two top players, loads of respect for each other. There was more mistakes made in that match than they probably make in half a season.
Recent history, of course, should Marco Fu win. Ronnie and Marco had a fantastic match in the UK Championship. Marco got an outrageous kick, actually, in that game at an important stage. Ronnie beaten by the odd frame. So they've got recent history as well. You know, again, have had good matches. That was just before Christmas. Mark Allen and Ronnie have had some good matches as well, so whoever he plays, it's going to be extremely tough. And at the moment, I think Ronnie has just got the edge over one or two of those sort of guys, even though he hasn't actually been winning tournaments. Ronnie would just needs to win a title again. It's nearly a year now coming up.
Yeah. Would that be on his mind, Jim, that he's not... He's
no, not at all. Obviously, he wants to win a tournament, but he can go in the match with the winner, Marco Fu, and Mark Allen, and then, you know, he might start flying, you know, so he's still in the tournament. That's amazing. Yeah. We take that.
Well done. Congratulations. The rumours are that you're going to go to the casino tonight with that luck that you've been having for the last couple of... What a strange afternoon, what a strange match, Ronnie. What did you make of it?
I'm just happy I didn't feel as ill like the other day, you know. I didn't enjoy that at all, you know. I felt physically, like, weak, and that's horrible to play, you know, like that. Well, today I felt physically all right. I know it was an abysmal performance from both of us, really, but I just kept sticking in there. And I think, you know, if you cannot lose your head playing like that, then, you know, that's a positive in a way. So, you know, Saturday is another however long away it is, so I'm just pleased to be in the next round, I suppose.
We're going to show you some of the luck that you got, and we're only highlighting it because you don't... I mean, I can't remember any player that's got this much luck, and we don't really associate you with that much luck anyway, but you got your fair share today, Ron.
Yeah, well, I didn't actually get on the red dot after the break, so it's a bit unlucky.
What's this one? This hits the brown one.
Oh, beautiful.
It chips off the brown.
Beautiful, mate. Beautiful.
You've got to take advantage of those, Ron, and I must admit, you're not known for doing it, I must say. You know, I sometimes feel that you feel a bit bad about it.
Yeah, because it's kind of like, you know, it's not nice, is it, to...
Yeah, I think you're more disappointed in the shot that you missed, really, than the fluke.
You've got to take
these flukes, haven't you?
No, I was disappointed, missing that brown by so far.
We were talking, while we were waiting for you to come in, we were talking about if players like yourself and Mark said we feel a bit of pressure because you're going for the record seventh, Mark is trying to get the triple crown and so on. What are you thinking when you're down there, when you're 3-2 down or you're 4-3 up? Are any of these thoughts going through your mind, or are you just so homed in on the match that you forget about them all?
No, I mean, listen, you just sit as from start to finish, you know, there's going to be, you know, ebbs and flows, and you just got to kind of be patient, wait your time. If you get on a bit of a momentum one, you've got to try and make it as much as you can, and then if the other guy gets on one, then you just want to just kind of just try and nick a frame just to stand the game and wait for your flow to come. You know, no one can play well all the time. You have to sometimes be patient and stick it out, and, you know, and you know, that's sometimes what you have to do. Mm.
Can you take your practice form onto the match table? How are you hitting the ball behind the scenes?
I think sometimes, you know, I think if you're confident of winning matches and winning tournaments, that's more important because it gives you that, I don't know, you just get into matches and you just, it happens for you, you know what I mean? You play off a few shots and bump, you're away. Whereas if you've got no confidence but you're playing well on a practice table, sometimes you go out and match, miss a couple, and you start questioning yourself. So I think the winning habit is more important, I think.
Yeah, I think you dug deep because it was a struggle, the match, and he wasn't punishing you, you know, but you still dug in there and you dug deep, you know, where before you might have got the needle, you know, so... Pleased to get through that match.
No.
We were looking at your body language when you were sat in the chair. Sometimes you're sort of nearly horizontal, but you're quite upright today, so it looked like you were up for the match.
Yeah, no, like I said, just I just felt like at least I was alive, you know, myself. I felt better, you know, last week or so. I've just been like exhausted, you know. So I think everyone's had it, you know. It's just unfortunate that you get it during the Masters, the UK, the Worlds, you know. But luckily for me, I got through and I've been able to get through today. So. Yeah, I'm happy.
You play the winner of tonight's match, Mark Allen against Marco Fu. Mm. Who do you fancy to get through?
I think both hard matches, you know. I think Marco's really playing well now. Much more aggressive with his technique, you know, he looks strong. Had a great result against Judd. Mark Allen is just a really tough match player, and, you know, he's good enough to beat anybody, you know, beat Johnny Higgins the way he's been playing the last couple of years. You know, he's a quality player.
Okay, and finally, you enjoying it? I mean, a great crowd.
I'm absolutely loving it. You know, you have to relish these moments, you know, at this stage of your career. You know, I'm just appreciative of every match, every opportunity I get out there, you know, and the longer I can stay out of this room, the better, I think.
Well, congratulations, well done.
Thank you.
There you go, the Rocket, Ronnie O'Sullivan, and defending champion, of course, safely through to the last four. His confirmation of where we're at later on tonight, around about 6:45, we're on air. The match should start about 7 o'clock. Marco Fu against Mark Allen. The winner will play, as I just said, Ronnie, on Saturday afternoon. If you're after a bit of live football, the Africa Cup of Nations continues. It's on now on Eurosport, so you can... hop over to that and watch a bit of footy in action. That's it. The defending champion, Ronnie O'Sullivan, safely through to the last four. Who will join in? Find out. We've got more live snooker coming up at 6:45. We'll see you then.